By the end of last week, schools across the country had begun sending children back home for the third term school holiday. Police have now warned parents to be extra vigilant for the safety of their children. According to police, cases of child abuse and trafficking are on the rise, with children as young as 3 years falling victims.
This period necessitates heightened vigilance from our dear parents, guardians, caretakers, and all local leaders regarding the safety of our children.
NABACA gave a number of security tips through which parents and guardians can ensure the safety of their children.
Avoid sending them away for holidays. If you really, really have to, maybe you should do it. But if you don't really have to, please keep your children around you, because you do not know what may happen to them when they are away. So additionally, be aware of potential for abuse of drugs among children.
Let's be cautious. This time is always desired by the perpetrators, since the children are at large. Meanwhile, you're busy at work. The children would like to go to different events that are organized here and there. So let's be cautious about this. Let's be involved in their lives throughout the holiday to ensure we avoid such happenings.
Meanwhile, the police have also warned the business community to be on the lookout for fraudsters who are targeting them, especially during the Christmas season. This follows an influx in cases of fraud registered by police in different parts of the country.
This is a very trying time. People are trying to find a way of surviving. Let us be vigilant and let us try and find out more about the people who are bringing such deals to us.
From the Kampala Metropolitan, dozens of suspected criminals were arrested over the weekend in an intelligence-led operation carried out along the Northern Bypass.
We focused on areas of Kasalosalo, Chebando, Chifumbira, Chamuka, Murimira, and the vicinity of the Northern Bypass, where we are registered 24 individuals suspected to be involved in acts of criminality along the Northern Bypass. They are currently detained at Chira Road Police Station.
Meanwhile, as we continue with the 16 days of activism against gender-based violence, CSOs have called for enhanced investment and allocation of resources to prevent violence against women and girls.
We call upon the government of Uganda to invest in prevention to eradicate violence against women and girls. Every effort invested in preventing violence against women is a step forward towards a safer, more eco and prosperous world.
Civil society organizations believe it is high time for the government to take a lead position in funding the campaigns against GBV.
We continue to see as a need is support for victims. And since it's 60 days of activism, maybe I'll begin with a support in terms of community support. We do hope for 16 days this year that we strengthen some of the support we have in our communities.
Gender-based violence is the most extreme form of injustice against women, and it is one of the leading structural causes of poverty. And this is something that concerns ActionAid very much. It concerns each one of us, because all of us are striving to end poverty.
The 16 days of activism, which began yesterday, are part of the efforts aimed at advocating for the rights of girls and women. ActionAid Uganda and a list of other CSOs will also be conducting a number of activities throughout the 16 days, all aimed at supporting survivors of GBV. The 16 Days of Black will run under the theme, Unite, Invest to Prevent Violence Against Women and Girls. Rachel Nachuala, reporting for the news.